wrap as to what to expect. Apurva Prasad as well as Sandeep Agarwal joining in to dissect TCS's quarterly show. And Apurva, to begin with you, just walk us through what the expectation is when it comes to that EBIT margin. Largely on account of the wage hike as well as the large captive deals, we're expecting the margins to contract, albeit very marginally. What is your outlook on the margin picture for TCS?
Hey, good morning. Thanks for having me. So margins, we expect about a 90 basis points Q1Q contraction, as you said rightly. The wage hike that have kicked in, so we expect EBIT at about 25.3%. So that's a 90 basis points Q1Q. That's not substantially away from the 26 to 28 stated intent EBIT margin band of the company. So yeah, that's where we see. But in terms of revenue, we're at about 3.5% at Q1Q dollar terms. That's on a Q1Q basis, almost close to like a decade best Q3. So a lot of things working for them.
Okay, fair enough. Sandeep, what's the expectation when it comes to the outlook on the commentary from TCS this time around? Because we are expecting that, much like they have in the previous quarters, there will be fairly healthy commentary when it comes to their deal wins as well as the demand outlook and trends across their verticals. Is that what you're penciling into?
Yeah, so thanks for having me. So I can tell you that if you read the heading of our preview note, we have on the heading put the title best Q3 in more than a decade, and I think best order book as well. And you will be surprised to know that I will not be at all shocked if TCS, HCL and Infosys on the earnings call say that they have become very selective in taking deals. That is the kind of deal momentum in the client market today, which has not happened even during Y2K. That much I can tell you. So it is a very, very robust take-up cycle, which is massively underappreciated by everyone. So it is a very big take-up cycle. There will be, as rightly said by Pratik Agarwal, the CFO of HCL, there is busting of deals in the market. And you should take that statement very seriously. That is all I can tell you. So there is a huge demand uptick, never seen before kind of scenario. And I think it is very structural. It will be there for next 3 to 4 years at least. And I see massive re-rating, massive for the sector, for the companies. The commentary will be very, very positive. I can tell you this much.
Okay. Well, Apurva, so then any hiccups at all that you anticipate? I mean, everything seems to be very much in line. Would, if you really had to dig for a needle in the haystack, would there really be anything that you'd want commentary on?
So I think, like Sandeep said, I think continuity of this trend is something which is what we want to see and understand. So the momentum certainly is quite positive, and it's a very broad total tailwind, which is not just helping TCS, but companies across the board. So in terms of the longevity of these kind of growth rates, double digit, I think that is going to be the key. At the same time, what can be the margin upside because of the change in delivery structure on a more sustainable basis, I think commentary around these would be seen at. So I don't think any material incremental headwinds really coming through. So it's largely continuity of trends and commentary on some of their important verticals such as BFSI and retail CPG, as well as some of the verticals which were more impacted by the slowdown in the economy. So how well that's sort of coming back, I think commentary around that will also be important. I think all this industrial demand is translating into very strong incremental sort of revenue addition. So you see they were adding about 1.5 billion or so annually. So that is almost doubled, so the next few years incremental addition is almost 2x that. So 2.5 billion plus in case of TCS. So that's where all this cloud migration, increase in cloud consumption, I think that's what is translating into. And TCS being sort of the bellwether will probably command premium valuations. So I think that's likely to continue.
All right, fair enough. And Sandeep, given where the stock's currently trading at, is there really any more scope for for a re-rating, or at this point it's just, as both of you have been saying, just to make sure that things are just running according to schedule?
No, see, we have a target price of 4,000 rupees on TCS from a long time, and it is at 40 times multiple, and I think my target price is for 12 months, this stock should not ideally take 12 months to reach there. So I am pretty confident on that. I think the whole sector will continue to re-rate in a very, very big way, because the ESG part, the corporate governance, the cash distribution, the buybacks and the sectoral tailwind. And remember, this is the first cycle in history of technology where margins are coming along with growth, which has never happened. So because of the change in business model and the change in, you know, execution, what Apurva mentioned just now. So that thing also needs to be taken into account. And I think, you know, I have worked in this industry for 10, 11 years. I have myself run a tech company. I can tell you from my own experience that, you know, people can say that, you know, there is a upfronting of demand, acceleration of demand and all that. But that is very impractical statement, because in tech, you can anything less than 3-4 years. So if there is a demand tailwind, it will continue for 3-4 years, or it is a false alarm. Either of that has to be there. I don't think this is a false alarm.
Apurva, the problem with not just TCS but the Indian IT is really not about growth. We all know that this is a sector that you need to stay invested in for a long time to come. And I mean, you know, we were just chatting with one of the market experts earlier today, and he said that, you know, it's these three or five boys within the IT space which have continued since IT sector came into its inception in the country, and they will continue to do so for the next, you know, as many decades as we can foresee. But the problem is about the valuations. And again, you know, with the kind of exponential growth that you are anticipating in the sector, and especially the big boys like TCS, etc., I mean, who's to debate what the ticker price or what the fair value is? But nonetheless, you know, just by historical averages, the stocks are very expensive. So what do you do in terms of the stock now?
Is that for me?
Yeah, Apurva.
Yeah. So, look, I think historical evidence is really a good way to measure this. So let me give you some numbers. So, the past 15 years, if you look at the top 10, let's say six top global players and four top Indian players, the market share has gone up from about 6% to about 27-28% over the last 15 years. And this has happened across cycles, you know, so pre-GFC, post-GFC, the digitization phase, and if you see in terms of incremental business that has come over the past 10 to 15 years, it's almost been like a 50% market share in that. So I think the fact that growth is not just a function of the overall industry tailwinds, but it's been largely a market share shift driven for the Indian IT over the past, that is something which kept on going. Now, if you couple this with the fact that the competitive advantage has actually increased over the past few years, and over and above that, you have now the big industry tailwind, you know, triggered by the pandemic. So I think these, if you put all these three things together, I think that tells you about the overall opportunity, which is tremendous. I mean, just look at the growth of some of these SaaS companies and, you know, the hyperscalers, the rate at which they're growing. And Indian IT is becoming more and more integrated partners with many of these and featuring in, you know, their top SI partners. So I think that is a very important curve that they've gone up. If you look at the learning curve, 3 to 4 years back, there were questions being raised in terms of, whether the talent pool is good enough to really compete with the best in the world. You have not just overcome that, come up the curve, but you've actually started monetizing these solutions and selling it to end clients. So I think the whole cycle of, you know, reskilling across technology cycles and, you know, being able to monetize that, coupled with the fact that balance sheet strength has only increased, the kind of payouts and distribution and some of the other aspects around corporate governance, those continue to remain very strong. I think all of this translates into the sector, which can command certainly higher multiples from a historical standpoint of view, which is why we are giving most of our target multiples are close to 2 standard deviation versus historical. I think this is a new normal that we're looking at. And over a period of time, I think that will tend to normalize. So we are quite okay with, you know, giving like a 27 times to a TCS or 24 times to an Infosys. I think these valuations can certainly hold on with even a scope of further re-rating.